Jay, would you begin this teleconference with some observations from the perspective of education?
Thank you, Jenny. I think Jenny has very nicely defined the purposes of our conference, to look at some new technologies, and then, perhaps the more important, to encourage broadcasters and educators to work together. That's difficult. There's a little story that administrators like to tell about problems in universities. Let's say that the world has problems, but universities have departments, and there's no necessary relationship between the two. And that's sort of the situation we're in now. We have some very clearly defined educational needs in our society, but we have a great deal of difficulty in adapting our traditional teaching behavior to meet those needs. And on the other side, we have a great deal of difficulty in converting some of our powerful teaching technologies to meet those needs too. Two important needs. First of all, a need for knowledge, almost a hunger for learning. In my own state, in Alaska, last fall, better than 6.5% of the population registered for at least one credit course somewhere in the university. A real need in a time of changing technologies and changing values to find some foundation in education that will help people to survive and to cope. Secondly, a need for equal opportunity. Our nation has committed itself to this. I feel that unless we, in education and in broadcasting, put this as one of our most important objectives, we failed our own country. In Alaska, it's geography. We have isolated rural communities that are very difficult to reach by our communication systems. In the rest of the nation, we have barriers that range all the way from language barriers to handicap barriers to economic barriers to you name it. But a whole host of ways in which there are people prevented from gaining education in our traditional mode. We do indeed need to learn more about how to make, how to reach out to rural Alaska and the rest of the nation who do not have equal access to education. To meet these needs, though, we're going to have to change some patterns of behavior that are pretty traditional. First of all, we're going to have to stop behaving as if teaching were talking and learning were listening. That's a Skinnerism, but it's very apt. It's very true. We really behave as if the only way to teach is to stand up in front of a classroom and either control the children or lecture to the adults, one or the other. I am exaggerating, but that's not far from the truth. Secondly, we use teaching technologies. We use telecommunications to amuse, to entertain, to pass the time, not to teach. And we've got to do better than that. We have to put education back into public broadcasting. I think the fact that we're meeting here today is an indication that we're on the road to success in that regard. To meet the educational needs of our people, to provide equal opportunity, we have to learn how to move words and ideas rather than people. And that, of course, is the purpose of our conference today. Lots of our institutions are beginning to pick up these pieces. Many universities, the University of South Carolina, is teaching business and engineering via telecommunications and with a two-way audio link. West Virginia University is teaching business education at remote sites, again, using video cassettes, in this case, teleconferences via telephone, sometimes electronic blackboards, a host of technological devices. You're going to learn more about institutions that have been involved as our conversation goes on today. We know how to teach. We know how to teach with high technology. We know how to provide the whole support system that helps the teacher and helps the learner use technology as an aid rather than as something just to sit there and look at. We know the technology, and we have it almost in hand. And that's part of what we're going to learn about today. We need to apply it to its proper purpose. The needs we face are very, very real. Let's hope that one day we'll be able to sit down and say that the world has problems and that we've responded.